Our coworker Larry, who you saw in the first lesson, has been putting together a recipes repository. Carolyn and I like these recipes, but we want to tweak them a little bit to be more to our tastes, so that then we can share them with our friends. Larry's okay with us sharing our modified versions, but he wants to keep his version as it is. Since Caroline and I both want to make changes, and we want others to see it, hosting our version on GitHub would be a perfect fit. It would be possible to get a copy up on GitHub, doing only things that we've already talked about. First, we could take Larry's repository and clone it to, say, Caroline's computer. This would automatically set up Larry's repository as a remote called Origin. Then we could create a new repository on GitHub on Caroline's account. She could then set up this new repository as a remote, which she could call whatever she wanted, say, our version. She could then push the changes to the remote, as we've seen before. And then, since I want to contribute to this repository as well, I could clone it to my computer, setting up Caroline's version as Origin. This is pretty involved, and it also doesn't give Larry any recognition for the work that he did on his original repository, since there's no way somebody looking at our version can have any idea about Larry's unless we link to it explicitly. To get a similar effect with less work on our part, GitHub has a feature called forking. This allows you to make a copy of somebody else's repository directly on the GitHub servers without pulling down the code to your local machine first. You can fork an existing repository and have it appear under your own account with just a single click. Then, to make your modifications, you'd likely want to pull down the code onto your own machine, unless the files are simple enough to edit directly on GitHub. Forking is a lot like cloning. In fact, a fork is just a clone that GitHub makes for you on their own machines. There are a few other side effects to forking, like GitHub keeping track of the number of people who've made forks on your repository, and the forks all linking back to the original. It also makes it easier to suggest changes back to the original repository, which we'll cover in detail later in the lesson. So, since Larry's version is already on GitHub, forking makes a lot of sense in this case. Caroline can make the fork on her account. Then we can each clone our new version. The clones don't need to know anything about the original repository. Since there are a lot of related concepts in the space of different ways to version your code, we want to make sure that everything makes sense so far. Each of the following diagrams represents either creating a branch, a fork, or a clone. Use the text boxes to indicate which concept is represented by each diagram.